Good morning students, welcome back to 10th standard science class. Let us continue the lesson of atoms and molecules, unit 7. In previous week, we learned about homo and heteroatomic molecules, relative molecular mass and difference between atoms and molecules. Today, I will explain about mole. That means the in SI system, the mole is the amount of a substance that contains as many elementary entities or there are atoms in exactly 12 gram of carbon 12 isotope. That means simply the mole denotes how many number of particles present in atoms or molecules. And the actual number of atoms present in 12 gram of carbon 12 is 6.023 × 10^23 number of atoms. This value of 6.023 × 10^23 is known as Avogadro number and it is denoted as Na. Next we learn about mole concept. The mass and volume of such unit particle in bulk of matter is known as mole concept. That is, the mass and volume of collection of particle is known as mole concept. How we calculate the number of moles of substance? Yes, the number of moles of substance is calculated by various methods, such as to calculate the number of moles of molecules and number of moles of atoms and number of moles of gas and number of moles of ions. And in number of moles of gas, the standard molar volume of gas at standard temperature and pressure is 22.4 liter. Next we learn about molar volume. 1 mole of any gas occupy 22.4 liter or 2400 ml or STP. This volume is known as molar volume. And next we learn about Avogadro hypothesis. The Avogadro law states that equal volume of all gases under similar condition of temperature and pressure contain equal number of molecules. That means all gas has equal number of molecules. That is same number of molecules present in all gas. It represent as V is proportional to N. V means volume of gas and N means number of molecule of gas. That is, the volume of gas is directly proportional to number of molecule of gas and V is equal to constant into N. And next, application of Avogadro's law. It used to explain the Gay-Lussac law and second one, it helps in the determination of atomicity of gases. Atomicity means the number of atoms present in a molecule. And third one, molecular formula of gases can be derived using this Avogadro law. And fourth one, it is used to determine the relationship between molecular mass and vapor density. And fifth one, it helps in the determination of gram molar volume of all gases. Next, we learn about the relationship between vapor density and relative molecular mass. This is the very important 5-mark question. So, students, please carefully to learn this. We already know Avogadro law is used to determine the relationship between the vapor density and relative molecular mass. Let us learn detailly. relative molecular mass. We already know the definition of relative molecular mass. It's the ratio between the mass of one molecule of substance to 1 by 12th mass of an atom of carbon 12. Here, the mass of one atom of carbon is 12, and 1 by 12th mass of carbon, that means 1 by 12 into 12, we get 1, and the mass of one atom of hydrogen is 1. So, the mass of one atom of hydrogen is equal to 1 by 12th mass of carbon 12 atoms. So, we substitute hydrogen atom in relative molecular mass, then we get relative molecular mass is equal to mass of one molecule of gas or vapor at standard temperature and pressure is divided by mass of one atom of hydrogen. Here we substitute mass of one atom of hydrogen instead of mass of 1 by 12th of carbon 12 atoms because both are same. Using this property, we learn about the relationship between the vapor density and relative molecular mass. Before that, what is meant by vapor density? The vapor density is the ratio of mass of certain volume of gas or vapor to the mass of an equal volume of hydrogen measured under conditions of temperature and pressure. That means the vapor density is simply mentioned as the vapor density is the ratio of mass of certain volume of gas to equal volume of hydrogen. That is, we compare the volume of gas to hydrogen gas because hydrogen is the very lighter gas. So, we compare the volume of all gases to volume of hydrogen gas. And according to Avogadro's law, we already know about that. That is, equal volume of all gases contain equal number of molecules. So, let us consider the one volume of gas contain n number of molecules. Then, the vapor density is denoted as mass of n molecule of gas or vapor is divided by mass of n molecules of hydrogen. If we cancel n, which is common, then we get 1. So, the vapor density is equal to mass of 1 molecule of gas or vapor divided by mass of 1 molecule of hydrogen. And we already know hydrogen is a homodiatomic molecule, that is H2. The hydrogen contains 2 number of atoms. So, then the vapor density is equal to mass of one molecule of gas or vapor is divided by mass of 2 atoms of hydrogen. And interchange the number 2, we get vapor density is equal to mass of one molecule of gas or vapor is divided by 2 into mass of one atom of hydrogen. And we already know the relative molecular mass in hydrogen scale is mass of one molecule of gas or vapor is divided by mass of one atom of hydrogen. Let us substitute the value of relative molecular mass to the vapor density formula. Now we get vapor density is equal to 2 into relative molecular mass is divided by 2. That is, 2 into vapor density is equal to relative molecular mass. That means the relative molecular mass of the substance is 2 times of its vapor density. This is the relationship between the relative molecular mass and vapor density. So students, I hope you understand about that today classes.